guess today, after I want to talk about driver personalities. And, well, oddly, you do have to look at the driver personality in yourself, where it is, how you spend it out there, your driver self. Can you do this for me? And I demand that for this situation. And I will not change, or I won't adapt, I won't modify. That is the driver personality. Okay, so we all have a little bit of it, otherwise we wouldn't have choice or option, wants. We would just be like whatever, a little bit of that's Mayflower, rollover type. And that type is not really normal. That's not a normal self. I believe we all have a driver personality in us, but when we're dealing with the driver personality, who is compound and tenfold normal, what others are, I'm like, well, you can blame it on things. You can say, well, they were raised driver personality types. They were raised that way, and so they can't change, they can't modify. I mean, the driver personality is used, it's just in everything. It's the ego, the controller ego. It's just a compendium. It's the Trump self. It's that. That's it. The be all end all, it's my way. It's my way. So the driver personality, I'm like, well, when you have these people and you know them and they're maybe near to you or close to you, what do? Because you can't just be wallflower if that is not your normal self. If that, you're already like, wait a minute, that's I'm not a rollover. You don't just run over me with tire trucks. It doesn't work that way. That's not fair. So these driver self, so they don't care. They don't care. They have their monster truck self, and it is not going to stop. It is just, they don't care about you. Really, when it comes down to it, whatever they're trying to relay or give or drive at that moment, they don't care about you. It's really the thing, the item, the service, whatever has to happen, that is the most important. And you are negligible on the side. These driver selves are so empowered by the moment. And yeah, my driver self, I know this self also. I try to take myself off that cloud as often as possible because it's a bad one. But when they only live on that cloud, it's just an enormous immaturity. It's an enormous immaturity. It's a place where sharing doesn't exist. It's a place where it's just sheer greed of I want this that way, And it's just like, well, when you meet these types of people, is it like, and then they actually turn them into managers, and they put them into jobs, and they're given like accolades in the society, when in reality they're just completely antisocial behavior. Antisocial. They are negligent in polite. They are not diplomatic in any way, shape, or means. They don't have those qualities. They don't have those assets. They try to be rulers only. Rulers only. So yeah, so what do you do when you know these people and you're like, well, a ruler only in the room, so I, it's a feeling of abuse, that it's a feeling of abuse by that person. You know that you feel abused by their manipulation. of you. You feel used by that situation. You feel absolutely used. And yet they don't back down. They don't back down from that monster truck self, I'll call it. They don't back down. It's like, that's it. They are the owner, ruler of the direction of the day, of what's going to happen. They don't bend. They don't bend. And it's just like, well, how have they been given this ability? I am still in a state of shock that they've been given this ability for so many years, whether they're young or old. I am just in a state of shock that they have been given that ability to be that cruel. To be that cruel. And you can look back at the old the slave owners. You can look back at those personalities, this driver self, the driver self personality. You can look back at that and equate it to the meanest people. The meanest people of all time. So when we're looking at Yao, can you guys, you know, get off that? Can you get off that pattern? Can you get off that pattern of being just an asshole? Just an asshole. Can you just get off it? Because you don't own people. You don't rule people. You are not a King Kamehameha or whoever, and you cannot just say this and you cannot say that. But unfortunately, they live in dominion. They live in dominion. Whether it is dominion of financial, dominion of family organization, they live in the dominion stature, and they have been given it. And people are scared of them. People are intimidated of them. And so in scared and in intimidation, they continue their rule as these, they call them diminuators, diminuators. There is a word for it, but yeah. They are able to continue because they are intimidators. And people will actually prefer to be intimidated rather than fight. Because the fighting with them is so bombastic. It is so terrible. It is so like, don't walk that way. Don't even approach the conversation. You will lose. You will lose. I often find that these types also, they're very strong. They're very strong physically. That's another part of their makeup. They're strong physically. So, anyway. So, what I was into doing was trying to like, well, you know, you can't put a veil over their cloud that they live on, their heavy monster truck cloud that they're just, you know, whatever they want, they get. But it does feel like, oh my gosh, I just want to live in a seashell. I would love to live in a seashell when those types of people are around. And just shut that shell and just say goodbye. And maybe don't notice me because they are that intimidating. They're that intimidating. Anyway, so yeah, so I'll look at them as the great abusers. The great abusers, the ones that use petty squabble as just their state of intelligence. And it's just sad. It's a sad ordeal that is how they prefer to relate to other human beings, is by constant friction, constant battle, and not not knowing how to share, not knowing how to be this diplomatic with understanding basic things. And they're bolstered. They are bolstered by others that live under this domination control. They are bolstered by these other abusers. And when these other abusers talk to them, uplifts their cloud higher and takes them away from sharing, takes them away from knowing, to be able to talk to others. So it's like they live in that weird, like, gang clique group, a gang clique that is a gang clique of mean people, that will not bend. Yeah. And yet they are allowed to hurt others. They are allowed to abuse verbally. They are allowed to intimidate because of this group that they hold and lock hands with. And it's a sad thing. It's a plunder. And I look back. I'm like, well, you know, is this something like, you know, like a war self that they just can't drop? You know, you look at the Vikings. Is it a war self that they just, you know, my life, my everything, you know, just, it's so childish. I can't even believe it. And in a way, I look so forward to the future, because people are like living together. They have like, you know, 5-6 people or more in one house, and they share, and less you know. Less, what do we call that? Combat in the house, you know, when they're perfect strangers. I think it's almost better. I think they're not as abused. They're not living in an abused environment of this terrible role playing where families are involved, where families feel that they have some power play, some kind of power structure over others in the family. So yeah, I'm really enjoying the new groups that do have house shares, and I just think they're wonderful, because there is that chance that those people cannot continue their domination. They cannot continue their abhorrent control over others in their family. Others that are their supposed friends. So anyway, so let's look forward to house shares, everybody, as the answer. Maybe this one man in the castle thing has just been an absolute disaster. It's been a disaster.